Chief Secretary intimates team of Parliamentary Standing Committee on Rural Development that 100 days MNREGA jobs could not be fulfilled due to less funds sanctioned by the centre. Hails People's Day observe under the theme, Know Your Constitutional Rights. Experts opine equal rights to tribals can bring peace and prosperity. Commerce and Industries Minister Govinda Skandhojam asserts that quality of people will improve if there is economic growth in the state. Demand continues for implementation of inline permit system and removal of wanted tag on Ratan Khomdram. Sit-ins held from Samuro to Sekmajit. NJC against brutal killing of Mohammed Farooq Khan and Mohammed Saddam calls for 48-hour ban on National Highway 102, Imphal More Road and Maya Lambi from 23rd June midnight. Hello and welcome to Impact News. You're watching Prime Time English News. I'm Tenshubham Sangeeta with the top stories and latest news at this hour. Manipur Chief Secretary Oynam Nabakishore has intimated a team of Parliamentary Standing Committee on Rural Development 2015-2016 that 100 days job guarantee under MNREGA could not be fulfilled due to less funds sanctioned by the centre. Speaking to a select media persons at his office chamber, Oynam Nabakishore said total cost required in providing 100 days job is approximately 1,838 crore rupees and centre has so far sanctioned only 277 crore 32 lakh rupees till 9th of June for the fiscal 2016-2017. Chief Secretary added that quality of roads constructed under Pradhan Mantri Gram Sadak Yojana and construction of RCC road at landslide prone areas were also discussed with the central team. The central suggested the state government to set up a committee to see the feasibility of starting a housing scheme for the state apart from the housing loan provided by the centre under Indira Awas Yojana. Chief Secretary also maintained that the central team visited Harauro under Imphal East District and inspected the central scheme taken up under the Ministry of Rural Development, Drinking Water and Sanitation and Panchayati Raj. The team led by Chairperson Dr. P. Venugopal held a meeting with the top officials of Manipur government at the conference hall of the old secretariat.
Job card five is in the 100 key. Some improvement did it only. The woman who did it for a shaka and a Peter of CNG. I'm not. Pick the number of now. Okay, but say is the 16 days. Come to the employment and a people on the PMGSY Gimakara, Chamberlain, Kungangi Lambi, Singi Lambi, and Chibi Matang Zita Chibinger presentation to it. Quality issue don't connect. Committee Sina, the Yarga, the Singi Lambina, and be a concrete point as how the Panita Harris in law. Recommendation Pirami, rural ki water supply ki tam sukana khana khana nai nai adu ga pe lete so ko technology si na ga sing ni testing to ra adu ko flat ki matam ga kan effective ko mi sing ga ma makal gi sing an anu ana ra je khaman ra ha so ga isu ni khane.
Hills People's Day was today observed under the theme Know Your Constitutional Rights. The day was jointly organized by Tribal Youth Council Manipur and All Tribal Lawyers Association Manipur at Tribal Research Institute Hall, Chingmairong. The function was attended by Chairman of Southern Hills Autonomous District Council, Chairman of other Autonomous District Council, Tribal Students, Tribal Organizations and others. Discussion was held on Article 371 of the Indian Constitution. Speaking at the function, Hills People's Day Program Convener, A.C. Racing said the function was organized in order to create awareness on the rights given to the tribal people under the Indian Constitution. He opined that hills and valley people can stay in peace and prosper once the tribals enjoy equal rights in the state.
Manipur si integration kai deningai Manipur si sandhi one leningai angamban so majority na minority sing so sok deningai na special provision yam nungshina state amasi leininga hena si provision si thambibni adugi damak ojik tycm ga or tribal lawyer association nangsi sinbasin ekhoi gi tribal gi rights phangbam thokbudu ekhoi gi rights si ekhoi gramaina khangna ga ekhoi mayamna phajana mathang de ekhoi gi rights to chapchana phangningai ekhoi smaina sinjabni.
Commerce and Industries Minister Govinda Skandhojam today asserted that the quality of people will improve if there is economic growth. Speaking at the launching of fiber-reinforced plastic boats and plastic fiber products of MS Ranjoy Plastic Industry at Industrial Estate Takelpat. Minister Govindas added that two industrial estates at Bishnupur and Thoubal scheduled to be inaugurated after the monsoon will enhance industrial products in the state. Minister Govindas said bunds and blockades hamper in the smooth running of business establishments. Minister also appealed to the entrepreneurs to keep in touch with the minister himself or any official of the department in case of any problem. Minister Govindas launched 100-seater plastic boat which will be used to ferry passengers between Thanga and Karang on Loktak Lake. Officials of Commerce and Industries Department, Central Institute of Plastic Engineering and Technology Imphal, Ministry of Micro, Small and Medium Enterprise Manipur, Principal Chief Conservator of Forest Department and entrepreneurs attended the event.
Akoi sida lois ban numitarani ban loi kiba koidri tarani um ban namulai rani an hairi adu itar tarani sida ban laiba matamda how the entrepreneur will survive, how the skilled workers will survive adu ne question dei adu na koi Imphal is the plastic park isi yam sauve area ma koi da darkar taba not less than 400 acre bu mama koi darkar taba hadi future expansion gi am lai na koi identify tore Imphal is ke area ma da masi ki sokoi yam ka no hona jari.
Demand for implementation of inner line permit system and removal of wanted tag on Ratankomdram continues in the valley. Local residents take sit-ins at various areas in Mayailambi from Samurau to Sekmaijing. Protesters held various placards like convert the two bills into an act, pass a new bill in state assembly, condemn wanted tag on Ratankomdram, JCLPS movement will continue, among others. During the sit-ins, all shops and commercial establishments were closed. Later, women and students form a human chain. JAC against the brutal killing of Muhammad Farooq Khan and Muhammad Saddam, both from Lilong Turel Ahanbi, Kalai Kong and Muhammad Zamir, who were seriously injured, has called for 48-hour bans on National Highway 102, Imphal Moray Road and Mayailambi from the midnight of 23rd of June till the midnight of 25th of June. It may be mentioned that late Muhammad Farooq Khan, late Muhammad Saddam and Muhammad Zamir were attacked by locals of Mayang Imphal suspecting them as vehicle lifters. Muhammad Zamir was seriously injured in the attack, while Muhammad Farooq Khan and Muhammad Saddam lost their lives. Speaking to media persons, JAC convener Muhammad Mustafa said the authorities failed to fulfill 4-point charter of demands submitted by them. He said in case the government fails to take action by the 22nd of June, then they will impose the 48-hour general strike.
Honorable CM now, Karigumba, the link tactics Sanabi Monda, Equibutambirapo, Jesina Karak, one Hanahana Tobuda, Equibutanga, Madugi Matata, Jesina, Minetarak, Equibori Sanabi, Tamin PBO, Hyperpuda, CM Nakarigumba, Tawaritaba, Masiko Jesina, Adumati Noisity, Tabutaway Quina Masigi, Tokiba Tau Siga Marilena, Lilong the Labour Prajapuna Mona, Jesida Kanba Pesapiramo Droga, Yanaki of Homsing as a Tabu and Heck Pound of Tripo. Lagliba Tang Kulumdoi, Tataruk 2016, National Highway 13 and Amasu Mailambida, Kung Nifunipan Giban Kozere.
JAC against the brutal killing of Elangbom Kanan Devi today decided to accept the body of Kanan. Representatives of JAC met Chief Minister Okram Ibobi Singh at CM's bungalow this afternoon regarding the case. Chief Minister gave strict instruction to SP Thoubal and other police personnel to arrest the culprit at the earliest. Chief Minister also assured full cooperation from his side and SP Thoubal regarding the case. On the other hand, JAC resolved to carry on agitation in a democratic manner until the culprit is arrested. A sit-in was staged today by local women at Kangabok New Market. On the other hand, autopsy was conducted at Janems today. It may be recalled that 21-year-old Elangbom Kanan Devi's body was found at a canal near Thoubal police station yesterday, after she went missing since the 11th of June. Youth Forum for Protection of Human Rights in a press release accused the police of negligence in the investigation of the death of Elangbom Kanan Devi. Elangbom Kanan of Kangabok Patu, Kulak Palekai was found dead in the canal just 100 meters from Thawad Police Station and 2nd Assam Rifle Camp on the 11th of this month, and a case was registered at Thawad Police Station on the 13th. The release also stated to send a complaint to the Prime Minister and Union Home Minister on the incompetency of the police in handling cases. Volunteers of All Manipur Students Union today handed over a 9-year-old girl who was working as domestic helper to Childline Imphal. The girl is from Ningthakong Ward No. 13. Her father is living with a second wife and her mother has returned back to her maternal home. Speaking to media at MSU office, Joint Secretary Yambem Ranjan said, a woman called Vidya, who runs a hostel on Ningthakong, took the girl for adoption and gave the girl to Acho Manohar of Sagolban Moirang Lerak as domestic helper. The girl is admitted to Sagolban Balika Primary School but never attended the school. She has been allegedly tortured by the owner. The girl ran out of the house at around 11 in the morning yesterday. Ranjan added that volunteers of SYDO Sagolban sheltered the girl and reported the matter to MSU.
Masajingbu leitalar dagi sakhang daba missing da pasha khara gi damakta thabak su na nabgi damakta masagi minungsi kokthokna thabiri ba bibiri ba masakhang daba singa bibiri ba si tobiganu thabak suon gani na thengnabi ba haitai lekai lekai gi missing thengnabi ba yarogadi mari leinaba department singda pau pibiu amadi angang dugi punsi bu kan madama ting pangbiu aduma thabak suon da yadaba matang lak taragadi khogi leiriba ngasi Childline Imphal gumba mari leinaba ngo sing amadi sarkagi oiba department singda
Lining Thau Sanamahi Temple Board today held the ritual of Lining Thau Sanamahi Cheng Hongba at Sanamahi Temple, Haying Khongban Upong Yupam inside 1st Manipur Rifles campus. Large number of devotees of Sanamahism faith offered rice grain to Lining Thau Sanamahi and Lemarian Sidabi. Priests and priestesses also performed Pena and Mai Bijagoi. The 15th Foundation Day of Voluntary Help Unit Committee RIMS was held today at Manipur Press Club. Those who attended the event paid tribute to deceased former office bearers of the committee. Red Cross Society Manipur Secretary Dr. Y. Mohan, Head of Department of IHPT RIMS Dr. A. Barindra Sharma and Senior Columnist Sharachan Thiam, among others, attended the event. Students of STNB High School, Irong Village in Senapati District, along with 8th and 24th position holders of Class 10 exam conducted by the Board of Secondary Education Manipur, were felicitated today. Laisio Kaising, AE of the CPWD Delhi, wondered why students of the government schools cannot score first division like the private school students. He appealed to the government employees to work sincerely to make shape the future of these students. He also appealed to the government to check whether teachers posted at government schools in hill districts and far-flung areas are working diligently. District Library cum Youth Center Thaubal Athopam today felicitated meritorious students of Class 10 and Class 12, successful AIPMT candidates and the 722nd ranker in UPSC exam, KHS Sivakantha at the centre yesterday. Sugnu MLA K. Ranjit, Khangabok MLA O. Landhoni and Chairperson of Thaubal Municipal Council, T.S. Shamo, among others, attended the event. Kuga Athletic and Library Association Kumbi felicitated students who passed the recently held Class 10 and Class 12 examinations conducted by KOSUM and BOSUM with good marks yesterday. The students were presented with Khangemam Ahong Singh Meritorious Award to encourage them. Let's take a small commercial break. We'll be back in a short while. Keep watching Impact News.
FI tutorial for CVSC. Kaishampar Hodam Lerak, opposite Tidim Oil Pump. Admission open. For second batch, 6 months foundation course for class 11 and 12 CBSE students. Class commences from 22nd June 2016. Hostel and transportation facilities available. Unique features of FI. Discussion period for every subject. Analysis of CBSE question patterns. Highly suggested study materials for examinations. Analysis of improvement of weaker students. Top faculties from reputed CBSE schools.
Please come and join. Golden opportunity for BTech aspirant students and parents. Discussion and counseling on engineering courses and its prospects. First time in Manipur on 19 June 2016 at Classic Hotel Imphal at 10:30 a.m. sharp. Experts from engineering colleges, engineering profession and social scientists will attend the program. Discussion and
how to choose career stream college.
Organized by Eduvalley Manipur and sponsored by Sri Venkateshwara College of Engineering and Technology, Chittoor, Andhra Pradesh and RR Institutions, Bangalore. For registration and details, please contact Eduvalley Manipur, Babupara, contact number 87948-57630.
Admission open. 6 months foundation plus CET course 11 science and humanities. Intact capacity, 25 students per class. Class commences on Monday, 20th June 2016. For details, contact Gurukul, Kaisamtong Hodam Lerak Maning, Airport Road, Imphal, in between 6 a.m. to 9 a.m. and 3:30 p.m. to 7:30 p.m.
ITC ki Ojar Singh na foundation ma di revision course sing da subject sing bu macha khaina ta pi ba ma di mok te sam di te series ki ana ai na ngasi pangli ba si da ya ma chaw lam te ba.
My success is the consequences of the hard work, patience and sacrifice given by the qualified teachers of ITC and the mock test series.
Welcome back. You're watching Primetime English News. Wangoi Assembly Constituency MLA Oinam Lokhoi today gave assurance to the local residents that the road stretched from Hiangthang to Langpok Lamkhai will be renovated soon. MLA Lokhoi further added that preparations are underway to distribute ration cards under the Food Security Act. He asked the local residents who have not submitted their names to submit it by 30th of June. MLA Lokhoi was speaking at the inauguration of a community hall of Majrao Mamang Makhalekai. The function was organized by Social Youth Club Iro Majrao Mamang Makhalekai.
No, na paka laudana ikoi kolas thaba ya ba season timing nong kitang parakpa nong chu drabo matam haiba tare da idi da soidana kolas thana na bugi sem chabu loira bani adu maibam lerak haiba sima suni koi ge maibam lerak te chakra ka maning majau maning lekai bukta ba ya lerak lai lerak si su pmj swai da koi loina mak hapchar bani PMJS wine hala hala handragan karino alternative state ki program da kai da lakom tam da han buduma hana pai khachana ba sima chu hona jage.
Renovation works of long neglected roads of Khongnang Phaidekpi Awang Puramakong Thongam Lairak and Waikhom Chawba Lairak under Langthabal constituency began yesterday under the supervision of Langthabal MLA Karam Shyam. Residents of the three localities thank the MLA for showing concern to the deplorable condition of the roads. Now news from the world of sports. Afros A Higher Secondary School Khabaisoi won the Under-17 Boys Imphal East District Subroto Mukherjee Football Tournament. Afros A Higher Secondary School Khabaisoi trounced Emmanuel English School Yangang 2-1 in the finals played at Kumalna Park Artificial Turf Ground today. The winning goals were scored by Mushtaq and Giri in the 27th and 53rd minute of the match. The lone goal for Emmanuel English School Yangang Pokpi was scored by Renault in a penalty kick. The tournament was organized by District Youth Affairs and Sports Office Imphal East under the aegis of Department of Youth Affairs and Sports Manipur. The closing ceremony was attended by officials of DYASO Imphal West, YAS and football enthusiasts. On the other hand, Lamlai High School won the Under-17 Girls Imphal East District Subroto Mukherjee Football Tournament. In the final match played today at Kumalna Park Artificial Turf Ground, Lamlai High School outclassed Poiro Khongjing High School 6-1 to lift the trophy. District Youth Affairs and Sports Office Imphal East organized the tournament under the aegis of Department of Youth Affairs and Sports, Manipur. NSU Naran Konjung Mamang Lekai and Langthabal Khopum Cultural Club will clash in the finals of the first state level open four-men's soccer tournament. In the second semi-final match played today, Langthabal Khopum Cultural Club defeated GSFC Kasampat 5-4 in tie break as the teams failed to score any goals in the stipulated time. 14 teams are taking part in the tournament organized by Naran Konjung Sporting Union at its ground. That's all we have in this edition of Primetime English News. Before we end, a look at the headlines once again. Chief Secretary intimates team of Parliamentary Standing Committee on Rural Development that 100 days MNREGA jobs could not be fulfilled due to less funds sanctioned by the centre. Hills People Day observe under the theme, Know Your Constitutional Rights. Experts opine equal rights to tribals can bring peace and prosperity. Commerce and Industries Minister Govinda Skonthojam asserts that quality of people will improve if there is economic growth in the state. Demand continues for implementation of inner line permit system and removal of wanted tag on Ratan Kumdram, sit-ins held from Samuro to Sekmajing. And JC against brutal killing of Mohammed Farooq Khan and Mohammed Saddam, cause of 48-hour ban on National Highway 102 Ipal Morey Road and Maya Lambi from 23rd June midnight.